Well, I think if you look at where does a civil society fit in, and in my view of the way I see it, is it's between people and maybe the state or the government, or in this case, Europe, those elected to the parliament and the commission who comes up with initiatives. So I see civil society in that space in between. And obviously, we've seen it has a very valuable role. We talk about Green Europe and where we are now, the Green Deal. We've voted last week in our parliament for the European climate law that has very ambitious targets in place. But I said that all came from activism and from civil society, maybe scientists initially pointing out about climate change, environmental groups, and indeed ordinary citizens having a concern about this. So now it's mainstream. It's on the legislative books and it needs to be implemented. I'd see that civil society still has a really important role there to make sure that that they're closer to those on the ground, to make sure that they know what's happening and that they can, in accepting as well, because it's one thing to introduce ambitious, say, climate change law or to say we're going to have a circular economy for everything, but actually, unless you get individuals and organizations and groupings to take that on board and to implement it, you're not going to have or you're not going to be successful. So I'd see a large role for civil society there in terms of educating and bringing people with them in partnership with the state and with the legislative body that is the European Union. So that's my. I hope that that answers the question a little bit, my view of where civil society comes. And I say it's not just greening, it's everything. It's in human rights, it's in speaking for minorities, it's a voice, it's providing a voice that really, for those that may have a small voice and may not have a strong voice and need somebody to speak for them. And you mentioned people like just trade unions, human rights groups. Those advocating for particular injustices they seem that probably in many cases the legislative body needs the support as well, needs that support, needs to hear that voice. So I think that we've done civil society plays a really important role, and I can't see that that's diminished now, and will be diminished, continue to play that role. Challenges and opportunities, these are always very broad. Obviously, challenges will always be to make their voices heard. Challenges maybe in terms of from a European level, I think if you look at it's not an extreme, actually, it's a reality where they can be where journalists, media can be controlled and muffled, if you like. So that's a real challenge, and that's where the role of NGOs is really important. In ensuring that's heard and that there's a strong reaction to those kind of injustices. So I think and funding is probably a challenge, let's be honest. Funding is always a challenge. Nobody can exist on fresh air, and organizations can't do that. They need to be supported. They need to have adequate support and adequate funding support. And so that's important as well. And that always needs to be to the fore. And to ensure that they continue to have a voice and are heard, and that there's an open door. I think more and more the role of civil society, NGOs, in whatever area, are very important. I see in my work, it's really important where how they interact. Like, for instance, I'm on the Internal Market Consumer Affairs Committee, and the role of European consumers and their voice is really, really important. Obviously, it's a Consumer Affairs Committee, so the role that that NGO plays both at European level and in the, and then the national body in Ireland contributing to that. So that's really an example of how they can make their voices heard. The opportunities are there. I think there's when you see even I was reading about Creative Europe last year or last week that's agreed now a new program looking at media. Arts, culture, and the role it has in society. Never before has it been so strong in my view, and what I hear at European level. So there's a real great opportunity there for those involved in that that sector to contribute. There's financial support, and most importantly as well, a recognition of how important it is. So I would think that from my point of view as a legislator, we see more and more that there is a role for NGOs and for civil society to play, and we want them, and we actually use their voice and their contributions in terms of dealing with legislation, and quite often be quoted or used in terms of supporting positions that we may take in the parliament. They should absolutely engage, because I can guarantee them that their voice makes a difference and that their voice is heard. One area where I think are really important now is the Conference on the Future of Europe, which was launched May 9th. It's now kick-started. And the idea at this point is that the input from civil society and from citizens will be important as to how they want to see Europe develop, what the future should look like. Should it change? We're happy the way it is. There are lots of opinions in this area, but this is a real opportunity. And I can tell you there's a real determination that citizens and their representative organizations would shape this discussion. At the moment, the platform is open, futureofeurope.eu, and it's there. I've looked at it again before this meeting. I've looked at it every day regularly to see what comes in. If you've an opportunity to put forward your idea, it may only be a couple of sentences. It may be an article you read, some of that you think is very relevant. You may listen into what's happening in other areas. You may look and see what ideas are coming from other countries. You say, yeah, I'd like to see that here. Or you may just listen and participate in events or organise your own event. It may be a small event, but an event or an event within your own grouping. If you are an NGO representing a particular area, to have an event, ask others to contribute and put those ideas forward, because it's only from, when we say grassroots or from the bottom up, that we're going to get the ideas and the input as to how Europeans shape, we can shape our own future. Like as I said at the beginning, I see civil society as a space in between the legislatures of the state and individual households. So it's all that space in between is where civil society can be really active in facilitating communication and drawing on their experience, because they are closest to the ground and closest to the people, and they have their one issue, which is really important. They have the knowledge, so let's bring it forward and share it. Don't keep it to yourself.